from the imminent evictions. And this also means that you are guaranteed a place in the finale.
Guys, tonight I witnessed daylight robbery. I'm telling you guys, if tonight had gone south, if tonight had gone otherwise, tomorrow on the news, people would have seen headlines, frankly speaking, with Glory Elijah at Multi-Choice dragging Big Brother by his dada. Hey! I was ready to go and fight. Did you see what Biggie did to Cross? See, eh? Thank God for Emmanuel's choice, oh. Thank God for Emmanuel picking Cross as deputy, which also came with immunity. If Cross had been up for eviction again this week, guys, Glory Elijah would have gone to fight, oh. I'm not even kidding you guys. I would have gone to fight. Okay. Peace, calmness, and beauty. You're welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Glory Elijah, and this is Frankly Speaking with Glory. I am the girl with the tea. And the tea of this particular episode is all about the ultimate veto power game. Guys, there was a massive twist to the regular live nominations and the Head of House Challenge, as there was no Head of House Challenge for tonight. Guys, there's a lot of story attached to tonight's rollout of events, so you totally need to watch to the end of this video without skipping one bit if you want to find out. But before I continue, let me quickly remind all of you to please turn on your post notifications for my channel. That is one of the easiest and fastest ways that you'll be able to receive alerts of all the most factual, accurate, and detailed analysis of the events of the Big Brother Naija Shine Your Eye Mansion as they unfold in real time. That's it. Let's quickly get into the gist. The gist, the hot wear. So tonight, there was no regular live nominations. There was no regular Head of House Challenge. As a matter of fact, just as we were hoping for, Big Brother put up all the housemates up for eviction this week, except for three people. And I'll tell you how that unfolded. Guys, it actually unfolded or came to be as a result to the introduction of the ultimate veto power game. Now guys, this is not the first time that we are witnessing such a game that comes with exclusive powers, yes, to alter the fate of the housemates that are meant to get to the finals of the show in the history of Big Brother Naija. We had such a play out in season 4, that is the Pepper Dem Gang season, where Fraud, the name actually sounds alike, right? So Fraud, during the Pepper Dem Gang season, had actually won the veto power that year, and he had swapped, or should I say he had put up Tacha up for eviction, yes, and that was because Tacha was always shouting 99 days, no leave, no transfer, I am confident, I'm not going anywhere. So she was more like the biggest contender in the house, so it was quite natural for Cross to put up you know, Tacha. And then guys, tonight's game came with some amazing rules. Now there were 4 different levels to the challenge, and each of those levels came with different points. Now level 1 came with kind of the lowest point, and then level 2-3 came with 30 points, then level 4 came with 80 whooping points. But the obstacles that was in the way for a housemate to carry out a single ball from the pickup point into the basket, guys, it was crazy. But crazily enough, guys, some of those housemates us thinking that they actually got the requirement, you know, of the game, guys, a lot of them failed woefully. Saga started with challenge number 3. He was able to put 3 balloons inside the basket successfully, although he missed out on one as it flew out of his grip whilst he was climbing over the obstacles along the way. Queen, oh my god, Queen had one of the roughest challenges. Oh my god, like at some point he felt as though she was deaf, or maybe the music was too loud, the tension music. Guys, we don't just know what happened, but Queen opted for challenge number 1. She was able to put in 5 balls, but then she completely wasted her own time, as instead of her to run on the bare floor towards the pickup point of those balls, she was literally climbing the bricks that she climbed to go and drop the balls. And Big Brother was kind enough to be calling out to her, calling her name, Queen, Queen, feel free to walk on the floor or run on the floor. But guys, It was as if Queen's body was the one that was playing the game, her mind, her ears were not there at all. So she ended up wasting her time, you know, regardless of the fact as well, or despite the fact that the challenge that she was taking up had the lowest score point. The next person that was completely confused was White Money, guys. It was so hilarious. Now, White Money also opted for challenge number one and challenge number three. Now, whilst playing challenge number three, guys, he first of all ran across the lane without a balloon. He was almost at the end, and then Big Brother had to remind him to go back and pick up a balloon. Guys, he did, but then he went back to challenge number one. It was just total, complete chaos. But then at the end of the day, he ended up putting only two balls in the basket. And then we had Liquorose, guys. Liquorose opted for challenge number four. She was able to put in two balls, but then she broke the rules of the game. Her hand was not supposed to touch the ball, but she touched the ball, but then she was also able to put in only two balls into the basket. The next housemate was Perry. Perry opted for challenge number four as well. He was also able to put in two balls. Now, guys, just when I thought that we're gonna have a tie between Perry and Liquorose, we had Nini. Gosh. Nini was a complete mess. To be very, very frank with you, she was a complete mess. Confusion was the order of the day for Nini. It was as if she did not even know what she was doing. She was completely confused. The same mistake that White Money made, she was running on the lane of number four with the balloon from lane number three. And Big Brother had to correct her that, hey, your lane is right in front of the balloon. So she had to go through that lane, and then the balloon flew off. Guys, it was just complete chaos. At the end of the day, she has zero balls. And then the next housemate was Emmanuel. Now, this was when the intensity of the game started. Emmanuel came with the speed and stability of Usain Bolt. Emmanuel was as fast as lightning. He was very, very sturdy in his steps, and he did so great. However, guys, he made a mistake when, after putting in three balls in the basket, yes, because he opted for challenge number four, which comes with 80 points per ball that you drop in the basket. So, after putting in three balls in the basket, at the point where he was on the steps, the buzzer went off on him. And so he quickly ran to the basket and dropped the fourth ball. And even the fourth ball still fell. And guys, I wonder how Big Brother did not see that. Because I'm very sure that these people can totally rewind and see how these housemates have played. But then Big Brother completely ignored that. Now, moving on to the next housemate that played, we had Angel. Guys, Angel was another bunch of confusion over there. I don't know what she was doing. As a matter of fact, she cheated in broad daylight. She opted for challenge number four at first, and then she used her hands to support the ball on the bat. And guys, I was just wondering, like, Big Brother, if this girl even goes further and you let this slide, then this game is a scam. But then at the end of the day, there was nothing to worry about because she still didn't make it to the finish of the game. She ran out of time. And then finally, we had Cross. Cross also opted for challenge number four. If you ask me, Cross was the only housemate that played the game perfectly, yes. But then he made a mistake because he was very, very fast, even faster than Emmanuel. He did not break any rules. He did not touch any of the balls that much. But what he did that actually stood against him was that the fifth ball that he successfully put inside the basket fell to the floor. And guys, Big Brother has said that it is the balls that actually made it into the basket that will be counted. So at the end of the day, Cross successfully had four balls with 80 points each inside the basket, secured fully. The drama that almost scattered the internet, the drama that would have made people troop to multi-choice tomorrow morning to go and campaign, to go and look for Big Brother to drag him by the balls and by his dada, was when Big Brother now declared that there was a tie.
It may seem as though we have a tie.
Tie, okay.
Let's play a game of sudden death.
Guys, I lost all my home training. I was livid with anger. Imagine, like, how the hell was there a tie? Cross comfortably scored four balls secured in the basket. Emmanuel secured only three balls in that basket. To the obviousness or to the obviousness of everybody that viewed tonight's game. And we all saw that Big Brother clearly cheated. As a matter of fact, Big Brother completely robbed Cross of that ultimate veto power title. Yes, guys, there's no caps to it. That is exactly what Big Brother did. I think Big Brother had an agenda, because all what I was just seeing once again was, okay, fine, Big Brother wants another Liquorose moment. But then, hey, guys, it was completely unfair because Cross merited that ultimate veto power title. So I was completely pissed that Big Brother robbed him of it and comfortably handed it over to Emmanuel. Because by the time they played the second game, Big Brother has scrapped out the level number 4. So they were left with any other level. And of course, it's normal for both of them to opt for level number 3 that had the second highest numbers that comes with the balloons. And so guys, Emmanuel was able to successfully secure 3 balloons in the basket. But then Cross, I don't know, that guy just completely wasted the opportunity as well. I think because he was completely disoriented. You know, when you put all your energy into the first stage and you know you did well, and then the second time, I felt like there was just so much discouragement and exhaustion, you know, seeping through his brains, that he ended up getting at least, I think, about 4 balloons or even 5. But he was so, I don't know what happened to Cross. He was not even able to secure any of the balloons inside the basket. And it was so frustrating.
Jeez! What is wrong? Fuck!
So at the end of the night, guys, well, just as Big Brother wanted, cheatingly, robberyly, yes, if there's any words like that, Emmanuel emerged the ultimate veto power of the season. And remember, guys, Big Brother already said that they were, should I say, perks, privileges, advantages of winning the title. So just as expected, Emmanuel gained immunity into the finals, number one. Number two, he had the power to pick the head of house of the week. Now, one of the advantages of whoever emerges the head of house of the week is that that person also gains all the privileges of the head of house, inclusive of immunity. So quite naturally, Emmanuel picked Liquorose. I mean, everybody expected that. If Emmanuel had chosen someone else, there would have been war in that house. Now, another interesting thing that Biggie introduced as well was that Emmanuel, being the ultimate veto power holder, was supposed to also choose a deputy to the head of house. Quite shockingly, and for the first time this season, the deputy head of house was also going to gain automatic immunity into the finals of this season of Big Brother Naija. Guys, let me tell you why I am calm right now. The only reason I am calm is because God touched Emmanuel's heart. Emmanuel picked Cross. And I said, yes, Big Brother, right in your face. I don't know whatever agenda you have, Big Brother, but hey, right in your face. Guys, I was so pissed there. And I was actually grateful, though. I was grateful that Emmanuel, you know, chose Cross as deputy. And guys, to be very honest, Cross deserves it. I mean, the guy has suffered enough heartbreak. Being swapped up, you know, with the veto power, you know, you are safe 1 minute, the next minute they are putting you up for eviction. Guys, he totally deserved it. And for once, let Cross enjoy the head of house lounge. I mean, this guy has been craving it all season, right? So finally, he gets to sleep in a luxury apartment in Biggie's house. Guys, that was what just made me happy tonight, nothing else. And then finally, just as we all have been praying for, Big Brother declared the rest of the 6 housemates that don't have any titles or any privileges up for eviction for this week. Now guys, you already know what's on my mind. I have people already in my head that I want to leave the house this week. I would love to know which people you want to see evicted this week as well. So please go ahead and drop those names in the comment section below. And I'll see you all on another episode of Frankly Speaking with Glory Elijah. And by the way, guys, let me know how you felt when Big Brother declared that there was a tie. Were you happy? Were you excited? Do you support Big Brother cheating Cross? Or what do you think? Let me know and I will see you guys shortly. Bye.